see is right in front of working sponge buses. I know sponges are coming off of it, pulling trucks in there while kids are playing and splashing in the water. I just see that as a big liability problem for the city and for me as a mother, and the sponge fishery. So I just wanted to put that comment.
Okay. Yeah, I think part of the question, if I can go back here, the distance from where the sponge boats are, because now they're getting pushed out another 8 feet.
With the seawall in between.
With the seawall.
Yeah, but I don't want, but those sponges have to come off those boats and get onto that pavement, and they've got to pull a truck in there and pull the sponges into the truck. There's going to be kids running around right there, and I think it's going to be a problem.
Well, part of it, was to, there was talk of, there's not enough for kids to do down there, so they want to leave, which means their parents leave, because their parents have the ball, that's so everybody's leaving early. Give them something to do so the parents can hang out with the kids, or one can hang out, one can go in. And they're walking through there now as visitors.
Well,
I know they're kind of focused and,
Yeah, I'm not saying it's not a good idea. I'm just saying, I don't think that's the place to put it. I think, now, where, if you want to take where the bathrooms are, for instance, and instead of having that parking lot or whatever, and put that right there, and maybe draw people down a little farther, but I think it would be a safer area for the children, and safer, and give the sponge fishermen more room.
And if you do close the whole street, you have a lot more flexibility on where it could go, even on the dock front itself, it could be over here, or down in here.
We were kind of trying to get it off to one side, so it is kind of out of the way, because we
this
see,
is the widest section
we,
down
we see this as being kind of the real sponge dock here. In fact, actually right now, instead it works down here, but that's a little note to add.
That's a question about the dock. How far out of the channel does it go?
Oh, it's only about 8 feet.
Okay, this is right where that amphitheater is. It's kind of the front spot, especially if you have the, you only have one shrimp boat on the other side, you usually one or two of them, and if you have a really big boat.
Well, you can see kind of what's, this is historical, what's there now.
Yeah.
We're not projecting out very much.
It'll go out 8 feet more than it is now?
At the most. Whether it's 6 feet, whether it's 8 feet, that's a question. But
part of that is to allow for the sponge workers to do their thing and visitors to actually walk by, get close enough to see what's going on, be able to get by. And there might be times when they have to close a section and they can walk around.
Yeah, I was just telling you that because the tour boats that go through there, there's more than one trip boat on the other side, it makes it real narrow at that spot. So it might be something to
Right. Well, I know over in here, by Cox with a fuel loading, sometimes they're doing three abreast.
I know.
That's
especially across for the north, the CP place, the big square right there.
Yeah.
Sometimes there's two or three trip boats. So maybe you can make an ordinance that would be something to consider.
Yeah.
So because the tour boats that go back and forth, it makes it a little tight, especially when we had the island, it was a little tight there.